Get a glimpse of this, Michael. The high-flying, kiss-stealing, limousine-ride Nature Boy Ric Flair here in the house that the Nature Boy built right here in Charlotte. Crockett built his entire company around one man, the greatest man of all time, Ric Flair. Best to ever lace up a pair of boots. And people in Charlotte appreciate the legend.
It's a matter of when.
Back in the back today, Charlotte, North Carolina, the hotbed of professional wrestling under Jimmy Carter for so many years. Magnum T.A., a former United States champion, came by to give MVP advice upon his upcoming match with Ric Flair. The Nature Boy Ric Flair and Batista teaming together for the first time here on SmackDown against the world champion Edge and the United States champion MVP. And that pyrotechnics display for the champion left us in a cloud of smoke out here.
Edge doesn't do anything halfway, Michael.
That's why he's the celebration
for a true champion.
That's why he's the rated R superstar, but will he be celebrating Sunday in Vengeance? So Edge kicking things off with a 16-time world champion, Ric Flair. Went for the cheap shot. Flair made it pay. And Ric Flair faced off one-on-one last week right here on SmackDown before MVP got involved. Batista involved in the fray before Edge delivered a spear to Batista. Sending a message to the animal. Ric Flair here in his hometown of Charlotte.
One thing you hate to do, Michael, it's wrestle a guy in his hometown.
And Batista. And look at the world champ. What's nothing to do with Batista two nights away from defending the title against him at Vengeance.
Mind games, Michael. This game is as mental as it is physical.
And for Batista, John, you got to wonder what's going through his mind. The animal is, he's backed you into a corner. His back's against the wall.
Batista has one shot. Batista's never been better. And Batista has been great the last couple of years of his career. But he's got one shot, Michael.
At Sunday at Vengeance. And you know what's interesting, John? You made a great point. Batista has never been better. Arguably the best couple of months of his career ever since WrestleMania. Yet he doesn't have the gold to show for it. He needs to win Sunday or forget about any other chance against Edge as long as Edge is champion. Oh, and Batista aggressive tonight.
The key, though, Michael, is so much easier to retain a championship than it is to win a championship.
Batista, who learned so much from Ric Flair, the dirtiest player in the game. Ooh, patented Ric Flair. Also, of course, from the game, Triple H. That Evolution was an unbelievable faction. Ooh.
Leaving out Randy Orton.
Randy Orton
from another hotbed of wrestling, St. Louis.
Randy Orton with a champion, a legend killer. Randy Orton, youngest world champion of all time, a chance to win the WWE title at Vengeance. And made to Batista. Quick tags between Flair and Batista. Held the tag team titles on two different occasions. It's a real interesting read, John, at WWE.com. Ric Flair talking about how he left Raw to come to SmackDown. He left the disrespectful, as he called him, Carlito behind, and ran into another disrespectful young superstar at MVP. In his words, covering a kick out at one by MVP.
Well, Michael, Ric Flair's the best ever. The best ever put on a pair of tights. People aren't going to lay down for him. They're certainly not going to lay down for him here at SmackDown. They're going to show him respect, but that's it.
But, John, MVP hasn't shown Flair respect. MVP came out here a couple of weeks ago, and he bragged about being the best United States champion ever. He hadn't even defended the title yet.
Do you think Ric Flair at that age showed people respect?
Oh,
it's innate with youth.
Oh. That's one of the things that makes people like MVP a great champion.
Cover, look at Ric Flair. Hook the leg and the head in a kick out.
It's what made Ric Flair a great champion.
Arrogance, cockiness, bad attitude.
It comes with superior ability.
MVP defeated Chris Benoit for the United States champion. Two straight falls at Judgment Day. Oh, and has let everyone know about it. Edge! Oh, Edge! Oh! And the distraction helped. MVP and Edge have taken control. Can Flair and Batista climb back in it when we return to Charlotte?